You mentioned the multiple sclerosis with your fasting mimetic diet, and also the fact that this diet sort of shifts you to a more fat-burning state, which is sort of in line with, it's definitely in line with ketosis, which you can get from fasting, but also in line with people that are doing a more ketogenic type of diet. And in your clinical study with people with multiple sclerosis, or was it in the mouse, one of the studies you had, I think it was the human study. You want to talk about that? You had a ketogenic diet. You had the fasting-mimicking diet.
Yeah, we did the same in mice and human, right? So it was a fasting-mimicking diet and ketogenic diet in both cases. And in the mice, of course, we could demonstrate some things. And these very clear effects, which was the fasting-mimicking diet causes the white blood cells, so the immune cells, as I mentioned earlier, to be destroyed, partially destroyed. And then it turns on the stem cells, and when you make new cells, of course, they're no longer autoimmune, right? So the original cells are autoimmune, they're attacking the oligodendrocytes in the spinal cord. Mm-hmm. The new cells, we've shown they're no longer immune. And these lead to about 20% of the mice being disease-free, right? So meaning 20% of the mice are cured from this autoimmunity, which is very much like multiple sclerosis. The other thing that happens is that the oligodendrocytes, with the inflammation, goes down, right? So meaning the general inflammatory state around the spinal cord particularly goes down. And so this is very important because it allows the progenitor cells, so the ones that give rise to new myelin, so they rebuild the spinal cord, they can now do their job and regenerate the system. So now, again, you have, as I mentioned earlier, for cancer, you have this coordinated effect, which you take the bad cells, replace them with the new cells, and then block the inflammation, rebuild the spinal cord. Now you can say, well, this is incredible. This is magic, right? Well, again, it's not. It's just that the body has to have this ability, like you cut yourself. The system that goes to work is incredible, right? Mm-hmm. And so it's like saying, you know, if I found a way to regenerate part of my arm by fooling the system into thinking that it just got cut everywhere, mm-hmm. right? That's, if you want to see fasting, you can see it like that. And that's why it looks so magic, is because it is an evolved process that has been, you know, been evolving for billions of years. And so it knows exactly what to do to fix a series of problems.
Yeah.
I mean, if you can see the wound as in the spinal cord, as you will see as a cut, you would think of as the cut of in the skin.
Wonder. I had this thought I want to say, but also you showed people with multiple sclerosis had improvements as according to some test or something as well, right? Yeah. With the fasting mimetic diet and also the ketogenic diet, which.
Yeah, and also the ketogenic. Less so with the ketogenic diet. Mm-hmm. And this is Markus Bock in Berlin that was the lead person in the study. The amazing thing is that a week of fasting followed by a Mediterranean diet, which is really a regular diet, did better than 6 months of ketogenic diet, right?
Oh, wow.
So continuous, right?
Okay.
That's what makes it very impressive.
So it was 1 week of fasting mimetic diet.
One single time, right?
Yeah. 5 days and then 25
seven
days.
Seven days.
Yeah. 7 days.
And seven
then the rest
days,
of Mediterranean.
And then the rest of the 6 months, a regular Mediterranean diet with
really just one?
Yeah.
Wow, that is
this,
really
is, this is what makes it remarkable, you know? So now we're approaching the FDA, and I think we're going to propose one cycle every 2 months, so hopefully that
for another trial, for another clinical
much larger trial. Yeah.
Is this something that it can be available to physicians that are treating people with multiple sclerosis, or oncologists that are treating cancer patients? Because you've shown that this is a very powerful metabolic therapy that can be used to. Honestly, it seems like if we're talking about getting rid of damaged cells and replacing them with the new, fully functional ones, it can be applied to a lot of diseases.
Yeah, there is no doubt. Yeah. So we're now doing mouse work in many autoimmune diseases. For example, we're doing in cognitive diseases. Yes, I think that what we're saying now to clinicians is the following, and to patients is the following. And sometimes we get attacked for this, but I really feel that this is the way to do it, which is, if there is a treatment, whether it's multiple sclerosis or another autoimmunity, or a degenerative disease or diabetes or cardiovascular disease. I mean, all these things we tested in some way in clinically. But if you can wait because there's something that works already very well for you, then wait, right? You shouldn't try something. This is not fully tested, meaning that we don't have a, yes, this works. You only get that when you do 2,000 patients or, you know, I say at least 1,000, right? And then you have to look at the statistics, you have to look at the response, et cetera, et cetera. We're not there yet. So we're saying, if you can wait, wait. If you cannot wait because, you know, you have multiple sclerosis and you cannot take it anymore, or you have cancer and you're stage 4, or even you're stage 1 and you're getting devastated by the side effects. So go to your oncologist, your cardiologist, your diabetologist, your immunologist, whatever, and say, I can't take this anymore. This is not working. And of course, there's got to be a decision made by the clinicians together with the patient saying, you know, should we take a risk in adding to this fasting mimicking diet to the treatment? And that's, you know, together they have to come up with an answer. Is it worth the risk? And to some people, it is. You know, we've had some people with Crohn's disease that said, you know, I can't wait anymore. And they did it, and they did extremely well, you know, after the fasting mimicking diet, you know. So we haven't published that yet, but, and so I think same for multiple sclerosis and all these diseases. You have to see where you're at. Can you wait? Can you not? Is there something that is working? And then make the decision on, is it for now, or is it for, you know, 5 years from now?
Yeah, I think that makes a lot of sense, Valter.